Theodore Roosevelt became the 26th President of the United States on September 14, 1901. The road to such success wasn't easy, and constantly through his life he was faced with challenges few could overcome, with the class and grace that Theodore managed. For young Tay, things weren't always easy. Born on October 27, 1858, to a wealthy family, he was the second of four children. As a child, he was sickly asthmatic. He had to sleep propped up in bed or slouching in a chair through much of his early childhood and had frequent ailments. Despite his poor health, he was a hyperactive and often mischievous child who suffered severely from tone deafness. He began to develop a lifelong interest in zoology at age 7, upon seeing a dead seal at the local market. He obtained the seal's head and formed the Roosevelt Museum of Natural History with his two cousins. Learning the rudiments of taxidermy, he filled his makeshift museum with many animals he caught or killed. Roosevelt saw himself as a timid boy who didn't overly excel in anything. To help battle his poor physical condition, he took up boxing lessons. February 14, 1884 was a fateful day for Roosevelt. His mother had died of typhoid fever at 3 a.m. As if that wasn't bad enough, his wife Alice Hathaway Lee died of an undiagnosed case of kidney failure just 11 hours after in the same house. Pain and grief caused by their simultaneous deaths was so great that he left his daughter Alice, named after his wife, in the care of his sister Anna. He wouldn't speak of his wife from then after, even to his daughter. In his diary, he wrote a large X on the page and wrote, "The light has gone out of my life." Despite such tragedies, Roosevelt graduated from Harvard Law in 1880 and entered Columbia Law School. When offered a chance to run for New York Assemblyman in 1881, he dropped law school to pursue his goal of entering public life. In his early years, he wrote more bills than any other New York legislator. But things just weren't going his way with the election of James G. Blaine as the Republican leader. During this time, he decided to retire to his ranch in North Dakota Territory. While in retirement, Teddy learned to ride Western style, rope, and hunt. Things were looking up, finally, for Theodore, until the winter of 1886-1887, being uniquely severe, wiped out his herd of cattle. This drove him back east and back into politics as he ran for mayor of New York City in 1886 as the Cowboy of the Dakotas. He came third. Despite defeats, he had many achievements throughout his political career. He was awarded the Medal of Honor in 2001. He won it for his actions in the Spanish-American War, as he organized and led the volunteers known as the Rough Riders against Cuba. He is still the only president in U.S. history to earn such honor. He also negotiated an end to the Russian-Japanese War, for which he won the Nobel Peace Prize. In the 1900 election, Roosevelt ran as vice president with McKinley. His time as vice president was uneventful. On September 2nd, 1901, Roosevelt first used a saying that would later be universally associated with him: "Speak softly and carry a big stick, and you will go far." President McKinley was shot on September 6th and later died in Buffalo on September 14th. Teddy was sworn in later that day at 3:30 p.m. He kept the same cabinet and promised to continue McKinley's policies.
In the 1904 election,
Roosevelt won the presidency in his own right with a landslide victory.
In 1905, he issued a corollary to the Monroe Doctrine, which allows the U.S. to exercise international policy power so they can intervene and keep smaller countries on their feet.
He decided not to run in the 1908 election, and instead led the Bull Moose Party in the 1912 election. It became the only third party candidate to come in second place. After losing the 1912 election, he decided to embark on an expedition to South America. He contracted malaria on the trip, and he died a few years later at age 60. A somewhat fitting end to a great man. Done in living life to the fullest, Roosevelt was a model to all Americans. The Dakota cowboy showed us true determination in the face of adversity as he overcame so much to make his mark hopefully permanent on the world.
Began. I can begin to know it, but then I know that it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd all come along? Touching hands, yeah, reaching out, yeah, touching me, touching me.
Cody.